Welcome back to Let's Play Pillars of Eternity Blind. I'm the RPG chick. We're going to go spend a night with a, prostitute? Actually, we've already done so, but now we're going to go see the most expensive one, whose name's Cyril, who knows something about this medallion. Yeah, she has a medallion that she owes this guy, Thristwin, supposedly.
Got it.
And for one reason or another, we've decided to help him on his quest, I suppose. You can go in, but mind your manners. Well, she's the only attraction in the room. Hello, Cyril. Gods keep me, thank you. Powder almost hides the circles under her eyes, and rouge dusts her two prominent cheekbones. Despite it all, Cyril is beautiful. She favors you with a smile she must have practiced and perfected. Hello, stranger. Let me make you more comfortable. It is rather warm in here. Kidding. Well, I guess we just slept with her. Can we talk to her now? Is that her talking? She's, like, very distant. Cyril looks at you curiously. Back again? There's something I need to discuss with you. She runs a smooth finger along your neck and under your chin. Just tell me what you like. It's extra if you want to bring someone else in, though. I didn't say anything of the sort. Your friend Thristwin sent me. He needs that medallion. So do I. Cyril raises her chin. I offered him half of his money, and he refused it. She's not even surprised by us asking this. She crosses her arms and paces in a slow circle around you. I'm sure he told you all about his broken clan. Did he also tell you that I got him where he is today? I really am sorry for him, but I'll bet you anything he lives better now than he did in Glamfellen. He worked a long time for a way out, and I'm not giving it up just because Thristwin suddenly got nostalgic. What do we could do if our resolve and might were better? Perhaps I'll buy it from you. She laughs. It's worth 6,000 pans. If you've got that kind of coin, I'll gladly help you spend it. No, it's okay. Yeah. How do we get in here? Oh, I didn't see that doorway. I'm not gonna take this, I'm just gonna read about it. The Exametil Plains are vast and fertile savannas to the north of the Eastern Reach. Though the climate is warm, it is less oppressively humid than the heart of Adir. Exametil clothing is heavily layered, using cotton and highly decorated wool in equal measure. Extensive beadwork is another defining feature of Exametil garments, found both in jewelry and incorporated into the fabric itself. Alright. Now, I just want to look at what this guy is selling. I'm going to read the descriptions. There's a bunch of them, but I think they're shorter than... some of these stories that we've been reading. Spectacular Speedum? The versatile poleaxe is a powerful and flexible weapon that can deal devastating blows against even a fully armored opponent. Its straight-bladed axe head is opposed by a hammer, allowing the wielder to switch between different damage types as circumstances require. So it's a kind of poleaxe. The Temporacil. Okay, it's just telling us about these weapons in general. Morning Star. Crooked. Bow. It's a hunting bow. Sword of Dionysus. It's a rapier. Wait, no. Void Wretch, whatever is better. Although this sword is quicker. Plus 5 accuracy as well. Huh. In the long run, this thing might end up doing more damage. Plus 4 accuracy. What is this enchantment? 7 out of 12. I don't know what that means. Huh. It's a pistol. Skapandaku's evil black arquebus. The Maverick. So it's a pistol. Gilt Blade of Lorn. Darkozy Paladini's Longsword of Inclan. I've heard of Darkozy Paladini somewhere. Habba's Hammer. Huh, it's a Warhammer. By switching from the flat side of the head to the pick, wielders can adapt the damage type to the opponents they are facing. I thought that said Hanover's Fist of Doom. It's a mace. Jarpy's Warhammer. Pike Jaw Rod. I might come look through this stuff at a later time. Semper's Faithful Dagger. See, I thought I was going to be reading all this stuff, but this is all just generic descriptions. Battle Axe. Silver Crow Axe. Sword of Pricks. The saber, the vile loner's lance, spear, Treve's conqueror spear, cloak of the theocrat, plus 1 intellect and plus 1 resolve, Don Paco's codpiece of vigor. It's a belt, plus 2 constitution, Azalin's helmet, crit. Multiplier bonus. So we can do crits even though we're wearing a helmet, which is supposed to do the opposite. Wages Hat of Leadership, plus 1 resolve. Bradford's Pear of Lusciousness, it's an amulet, plus 10 defense against spells. And the Willowstone of Dionysus, plus 15 max endurance, another amulet. Nothing today, my good man. Well, let's get out of here. We paid 1,000 for nothing, my god. Well, easy come, easy go, right? I guess we'll go back at some point and tell him. Nah, we didn't do it. I'd like to, demand 1,000 from him, actually.
Good day, stranger.
I wonder if it's daylight yet. Then we could explore those piers and stuff. Docks, piers, boardwalks. Whatever you want to call them. Yes! Oh no, it doesn't look like we can explore more than before. What is that, blood from where that guy was attacked? Can we walk through the water? Animat? What the hell? What's an animat? All I'm saying is we autosave when we left the salty mast, so if we die, there's that. Alright, so this thing, is obviously going to attack us. We've got Geffa's boon and Cyril's boon. Plus 2 athletics, plus 2 con, and plus 2 dexterity. Yeah, Theodas had a lot of fun for herself and slept with 2 women. And she's ready to fight something. She's ready for activity of a strenuous nature, but quite a different kind of activity. And I'll just leave it at that. I don't know what this thing is. Some kind of conjured foe.
Eh?
And there's 3 of them. Oh, there's a rain blight and 2 animats. Okay, and we didn't even fire. There's a whole bunch of them. Okay. How about soul ignition on this thing? I'm not gonna throw the fireball yet, because they're still running. I'll just wait a second. I don't know if I can knock these things down, but I'm sure as hell gonna try. Holy radiance, yeah. Whatever that is. Wounding shot. Alright. Go with your fireball. Was he interrupted? Dare. He was hit, that's for sure. Nice. Again. Armor of Faith. These things are tough. Oh, that one animat's almost dead. Who's here? You dare, okay. Try a knockdown again. I don't know if they work. Restore light endurance. Right.
Boy.
Soul Shock off of Adair. Rain Blights. Will this work? Necrotic Lance?
Lava will be-
Lost 40 crore damage, nice. Additional effects for 9.8 seconds. Arcane Assault while we do the additional effects. It has fallen. See if we can finish off this Rain Blight. Theodess, we're just gonna hit this one. Kanna, hit that one. Edair can hit this one. Durance. Sure, why not? Blessing. Boom. Oh! Sakani. Restore light endurance here. Okay, Wolfie.
Boy.
Huh. So when we go into the water, there'd be danger. And we can't get to this stuff because it's underwater? That is not fair. That's not fair. I want this stuff.
Eh?
Oh, is it because I was trying to pick it up with a fox? Never mind. Ingwithin Dagger. This dagger is engraved with symbols and runes. Despite its age, it appears to be in excellent condition. Ingwithin Shield. Ingwithins are legendary for their architecture and magical abilities, but their metal craft leaves much to be desired. This bronze shield is beautiful, but heavy and slow. Primal Warder. We saw that merchant selling it up there. Shattered Animat Armor. This Adra armor has cracked and shattered into fragments. You can barely see the original shape of the armor. Here's this copper. This is kind of like a mystery going on here. No spoilers. No spoilers, please. That was certainly interesting.
No problem.
Should I be sneaking then?
Shh.
Is this going to be a common occurrence? Can't go on here. We can go this way. Oh yeah, there's fog of war here. I did not anticipate this. We've looked at that boat. What's that? There's a ghostie or something there. Mud squelches underfoot. Crabs scuttle out of the debris. Hello? Huh. We can't do anything with that. That's interesting. We're all like shimmery and stuff. Dun dun dun.
Layla.
Layla. Ooh, we got here. Ingwithin Scepter Spike. This looks like the top portion of a scepter. There's a short spiraled spike at one end for attaching the finial. I don't know what a finial is. I'm guessing it's part of a scepter. Now, I wouldn't be surprised if this is a quest item. It is. Cool. Barnacles encrust the hull of this beached boat. Something, the jagged adder fingers most likely, has clawed deep rifts in the wood. Whoever tried to sail through them must have been desperate or inexperienced. You can get your experience over there at the Salty Mass, you know what I'm saying? Ooh!
Something over there!
Not trapped, is it? Nope, it's a wooden box with a potion of minor endurance. 10 silver finnings and 20 silver lushi thingies. That's the other benefit to sneaking everywhere.
Hey.
Oh.
Eh?
Thought he was about to say something. Didn't realize I clicked on him. Okay, we're back by the bodies here. It's in the box. People don't know all this stuff, all this treasure is here. Here's the base. This looks like the base of a scepter. It seems to have broken cleanly from the section above it. Cool! We gotta find all the pieces? Can we put them together, or are they already put together? Scepter base. I can't, like, move it around and stuff. Okay. I guess it'll put itself together whenever I get all the pieces. Is in the box over there. Well, that's up top. I bet you there's something to fight in here. A water dungeon right in the middle of a town. Oh, cool. Here's another hidden thing.
Now this I haven't seen before.
Neither have I. Three pearls. Pearls are formed in the mouths of clams and similar animals. They are hard spheres, most often white, that show faint iridescence. Being difficult to come by in large numbers, they are every bit as rare as many precious stones and consequently just as expensive. So 36 gold, golden dukes. Dead endo. Hail, sailor. You've been this way? I'm not completely sure if you've been this way. No, there's some shadows here. Oh, and there's a beastie. Now we get to at least attack. Before we're seen, these things run pretty quickly, even through the water. Die.
No.
Okay, you're right here, so wounding shot, I guess. I don't know, on the rain blight, it's first. Thank you. soul ignition on this thing. But can't hit it. I can't hear anything yet. Okay. I guess just close in for... so we can see him. Can't even see them. No. Ditto there. So have him run up. And have Canna, of course, run up.
Ready, Watcher.
Ready, Watcher. I like that. Okay. Unfortunately, we're out of fireballs. Necrotic Lance on this animat thing. Well, this will hit us all. Barely. Holy Radiance. He's still running, too. Okay.
Love.
It was like... Oh, Sagana got hit. That was like electricity. Lightning. I guess so. They're rain blights. They're like storm elementals or something. That's pretty cool. Not just purely water. It's cool even though they're using those powers against us. I still find it fascinating. Alright. Right, I didn't have her go yet. Soul Ignition on that animat. Aloth hasn't gone yet. Oh. Unfortunately, Canna didn't get the benefit of that. Itumak. Grazed? You realize how much focus I just used there? Grazed it? Who's here? Edir, Sagani. They're too spread out. I didn't intend for Canna to be all the way over there. Again. Necrotic Lance. And, yeah, we're just gonna wade into battle here. One more time. Oh wait, can I redirect? Yeah. On this rain blight instead. Knockdown? Who's this? You dare. I don't know if we can knock down rain, but... Okay, there's only one left. Everyone pile on the last rain blight. Oh my god, Canna. We really need to rest when all this is over.
Yes?
To make it up for you, I'll let you collect the goods. Same stuff as usual, right? Yeah. Hmm. Mussels cling to the bricks and planks, their shells sharp enough to cut flesh. Well, we'll stay away from that thing then. There's another one here. Miss one, Canna. Oh, there's something over here.
Eh?
Let's sneak just in case there's hidden stuff. Don't you shush me. I'll show you. Hope you find the rest of this scepter, that'd be cool. Nope, just some snow caps. Imatil? Imatil? Oh, there's another box thingy. Ingwithin's scepter shaft. This broken shaft looks like part of a scepter. Inscribed runes invoke and channel the wielder's essence. I want to put it together. How many pieces can there be to a simple scepter? Yes, I can't move. That's the broken blade, but we got this, the spike, the shaft, and the base. What's left? We have to find someone to put it together. Maybe Dunstan, is that his name? In the Crucible Keep, if they don't all kill us when we go in there. Let's check around for any more stuff. Secrets. Reveal your secrets. No, huh? Can we get up from here? Can we go up there? I guess we've explored this whole area. Did we talk to this guy before? There was a fisherman here before, wasn't there? Some payday this turned into. An old man paces the dock and looks out over the water. He's fussing over something large and round, which he constantly shifts from one hand to the other. You're not certain whether his wide-eyed, gaped-mouthed expression marks surprise or fear. It seems he isn't either. You, don't look like a guard. He examines you and your equipment more closely. Say, you wouldn't be interested in making some coppers, would you? That's okay, we've only got 80 other quests going on. We can take another. He shows you the object in his hand. It's a large round opal with Ingwithin runes carved into it. It glistens with his sweat. Joy, see that ship that went down over there? I've been looking for someone to help me recover some missing cargo. Tell me more about this missing cargo. He licks his lips. We started in Cold Morn and were making our way down the river, loading and unloading as we went. Business as usual. Give me the short version. What exactly happened? He massages the opal in a clammy palm. When we reached Aenor's Rest, we may have agreed to take on a few crates from some place called Clearban Relag. A couple of the lads snuck a peek at the cargo, saw suits of armor and a broken scepter. Hey, hey! We got broken scepter pieces. He shrugs. Don't know why anyone would want a broken anything, but these animancers are... Animancers will buy dirty stockings if you say they come from the ruins. He closes his hand around the opal in a white-knuckled grip. We were almost to Defiance Bay when the screaming started. Wow. I've seen my share of barroom brawls, but this sounded different. I was topside with the captain, but he and the first mate went below decks to see what all the commotion was about. When they didn't come back, I looked into the hold. He shudders. I saw one of those suits of armor, walking around all by itself. It was covered in blood. When it saw me, it started running for the hatch, so I closed it. He squeezes his eyes shut. So how did the ship get here? We'll stay neutral here. He rolls a stone between his hands. I'm just a deckhand, but I was the only one left. I piloted the ship as best I could, but I hit rocks as we were passing Brackenbury. I barely made it to Ondra's skiff before I had to jump overboard and swim for the docks. I'd given up on our cargo, not to mention the payday, when one of the lads pulled up in his nets. He shows you the opal again. It's part of that scepter. From what I recall, there were three other pieces. Ding! And I'd bet you anything they're somewhere in the shallows, too. If anyone could find them, there'd be profit to follow. I actually already found the missing pieces. His bristled eyebrows rise to a peak. You mean you got past those armored monsters? I don't know how. He shakes his head. That's where they came from. I figure they just naturally appear in the water. Listen, if you're willing, I'll give you this last piece. He holds up the opal, and the name of someone who'll buy it all. All I want is 200 pans for getting the cargo here. Sound fair? It's all interesting ideas. You want 200 pans for locking the rest of the crew in the hold and sinking the ship? Look, He rubs the back of his sunburned neck. How about 100? I'm just trying to get by until the next job. Oh, yeah, we'll give him 100 copper. Fair enough. He accepts your money and gives you the opal. It's still warm from his hands. We gotta wipe the sweat off this friggin' thing. You'll want to go to the Brackenbury Sanitarium and find Nens. She'll know more about this artifact, and I know for a fact she's bought them from our crew before. All right, back to the sanitarium. Imitil gazes out over the water. Anything else you need? Imitil doesn't sound like a Deerwooden name. That's because it isn't. I'm from the Eximitil Plains. Exactly, he's only missing a few letters from Eximitil. A broad savanna north of the Deerwood. Not so different from the ocean, in a way. There are places where you can stand and turn a full circle and see nothing but the winds making waves in the grass. He watches the surf lapping against a wrecked boat. But at moments like this, I wonder what business a plainsman like me had taking to the water. How's business? He spits into the water. Patooey! I'll be glad to sail with captains who are more careful about their cargo from now on. I don't give a worm's wings about the Duke's trafficking laws, but I'm too old to find ancient horrors. Fight ancient horrors. He takes a deep breath of the salty air. I just want to enjoy my twilight years doing an honest day's work. Tell me about Andra's gift. He scratches his sunburned scalp. Scritch, scritch. We've got docks, fishing, and steady ship traffic. All this, he waves at the listing shanties crowded against one another. This sprang up around the docks. It's the poorest district in Defiance Bay, but one of the liveliest. He grins. And for lively, nothing beats the salty mast. You'd do better to ask a younger man than me if you want to know about that place. He nods towards a large round building to the east. Yes, it's actually the first place we checked out. Farewell. Okay, so we need to put these pieces together. And we can't put them together. We need to find someone to put them together. Inguithan ruins have been engraved on the surface of this polished opal. It looks like a scepter finial. Cool. Pretty awesome. The ropes dangling from this crane sway in the ocean breeze. Alright, guys. I have not seen these people. Thanks for watching, see you next time, and endure. In enduring, grow strong.